Hi guys, I'm glad everyone is here. Thank you for joining me. I got a message today there on YouTube about all the earthquakes that are being felt in Dillon, Montana. 52 earthquakes within the last week, and I believe the largest one was a magnitude 3.3. It was 9.4 kilometers in depth, or 5.8 miles below sea level. As you know, all earthquakes are measured from sea level, not far from the Clark Canyon Reservoir. In 2005, near Dillon, there was a magnitude 5.6 earthquake. It is an earthen dam built in 1960-1961. You can see this slope here. And then using Google Earth, there's the road beside it, gravel on one side, etc. Over here would be the discharge for overflow. That would be the spillway. And it kind of reminds me of that one spillway they had there. What was it, California? That failed. Yeah, I wonder about the maintenance on this spillway. Going back to these recent earthquakes right there. This 3.3 is within the area of the uplift that is currently occurring there at Yellowstone. And the green line is the Trans-Challis Fault System, which I talked about in my last report there about Yellowstone. The green line's the fault system. Right there's the earthquake. 52 in this location. The most recent was a magnitude 1.9. which was 0.8 miles in depth. Before that, there was a 2.6, 4.4 miles in depth. And we'll just come down here and look at some of these. They're all about magnitude 1s or greater, 1.5, 1.7, 2.0, 2.1. Yeah, a lot of 2s. And remember, when Hank Hessler from the USGS website said when they started having earthquakes of a magnitude 2, they would be concerned. But I assume that is within the location of the park. So bringing it out farther here on the USGS webpage, these are all the recent earthquakes within the last week. This one here is a 2.4. Let me bring it in because I want to cover this area once again, the Madison River area, which I talked about the uplift that is going on. I had listened today, a woman who worked for USGS, a Susan Huff, and she made a very interesting comment in one of her videos. And I want to quote her. This is what she said. There is a climate where science, there is a body of knowledge, there is things we can say, and there is a contingent out there that has politicized it. Yeah, things they can't say. So I thought it was interesting where she put in that comment. There is things we can say, and there is a contingent out there that has politicized it. So yeah, read between the lines. So sometimes science is politicized. The politicization, I'm being tongue-tied here, of science for political gain occurs when government, business, or advocacy groups use legal or economic pressure to influence the findings of scientific research or the way it is disseminated, reported, or interpreted. I know USGS Michael Pollan watches my reports. I don't think it was a coincidence he talked about all the earthquakes that have been occurring near Stanley, Idaho, after my last report about Yellowstone, and all the earthquakes that have been occurring within that area along these different fault systems that run up from the Snake River Plateau, or Snake River, where Yellowstone's hotspot used to run. He would have you believe that all these earthquakes that have been occurring are aftershocks from last year's 2020 magnitude 6.5 earthquake. I believe he has politicized. He's been politicized, I guess you could say, because they want people to continue to visit our parks. They don't want the people to get scared. It's all about money. Those of you that have followed me in the past know that during Yellowstone's last major eruption, it did an unzipping of the caldera, doing a counterclockwise rotation, starting up here somewhere in the Madison River area, and then going down here towards Heart Lake before the two resurgent domes collapsed simultaneously, which created the super eruption. There has been probably at least 40 smaller eruptions since its last major eruption. And what we got going on right now is uplift in this area, once again, which could be an indication of a buildup of magma, the heated water, or pressure or tension, which could create another large earthquake, which happened in 1959, resulting in, 12 deaths? That was a magnitude 7.3. So either we're going to have another earthquake coming, or going to have hopefully a smaller eruption in this area, and I'm going to show you the uplift charts as of today. The first one I'm going to show you here is Hedgin Lake. Is going to be P172. After being offline last year, it is showing a steady uplift. And let me bring this down so you can see the date. And we'll come, I'll just bring it over. Make it smaller there for you. Bring this over. Right there. It's been steadily rising since they started monitoring in probably 2009. Station P456, there's Hedgin Lake right there. There's the monitor, and you'll see up since 2009. And this is what it's currently showing. Let me make that bigger. There you go. The next one I'm going to show you is P714. And let me bring this down here. Right there, there's Yellowstone Lake, there's Hedgin Lake. Now this says it was plotted as of December 3rd, and it goes, for a week. I guess they're doing it for a week. Let me make that bigger for you. So they take uplift readings every week. Let me zoom out again so you can see this is the highest it's ever been. Since 2014. Let me bring this over. There's 2014. And yeah, it's higher now than it was at its highest point in 2014. Next one I'm going to show you is P711. This is the map. There's Yellowstone Lake. There's Hedgin Lake right there. And this one too is about the same uplift when it had its highest uplift in 2006. And I'll make that bigger. Okay, this is now, and we'll pull it over to 2006. There you go. All right, let me bring it back over. Almost as high as it was at its highest point in 2006. So the next one I'm going to show you is the Norris Geyser Basin area. Which one is it? Let me find it here again. Right there. And the reason I'm showing you this is to show you, give an example of how the bulge there is by the Madison River. And farther east you go, the bulge gets even less. So let's bring this up and make it bigger. 2018, that's when they had that swarm of geysers erupting, and this is what it's currently showing. And I'll bring it all the way back. Let me pull it down so you can see the date. And they started monitoring in 2004. We'll bring it over. I I am not being politicized by anybody, and here in Wikipedia it shows you all the different sciences that are being controlled, manipulated. We got global warming, intellectual design, tobacco and cancer, eugenics, social justice, and then it's got, I haven't read the whole article. It mentions George W. Bush, the Surgeon General, Food and Drug Administration, Trump Administration, climate change, health, and what's going on with the Biden Administration. It's part of an effort to refresh and rejuvenate our national science and technology strategy. President-elect Joe Biden announced before taking office that he will elevate the role of Director of the Office of Science and Technology Policy to a cabinet level. Biden's removal of Betsy Weatherhead from her role as Director of the National Climate Assessment has been criticized as being politically motivated. So I gotta be fair, it says Trump administration. The Trump administration marginalized the role of science in policymaking, halted numerous science research projects, and saw the Department of Sciences, who said their work was marginalized or suppressed. George W. Bush administration. In 2004, the Denver Post reported that George W. Bush's administration had installed more than 100 top officials who were once lobbyists, attorneys, or spokespeople for the industries they oversaw. At least 20 of these former industry advocates helped their agencies write, shape, or push for policy shifts that benefited their former industries. I'll give you a link down below and you can read this if you want. The last two scientists they've had in charge of Yellowstone, I know darn well they've been politicized. They've been controlled, told what to say, told what not to say. Yeah, it's all about the money. So anyways, that's my thought. I think you got a larger earthquake coming. Hopefully that's what it's going to be and not a small eruption or any kind of eruption. But these earthquakes are not aftershocks from last year's earthquake. No, they're not. I'm sorry. I disagree. And like I said, these quakes are right along that one fault system. I talked about it, how it goes up all the way to British Columbia. And it's right along the rim of the uplift of Yellowstone. So thank you very much for watching. I hope everyone has a very Merry Christmas. I'll do more reports about Yellowstone between now and the holiday. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you for your questions and comments. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.